Welcome back to the course. So now we are starting to code our sticker album challenge. And for the time being, we only use the Python standard library. So what does it mean? We are only using the built-in functions and modules that are part of the standard Python installation. And we are not using any other packages like NumPy or Pandas, which might be faster or have a better performance. Now we are just sticking to elementary coding structures like for loops, while loops, lists, and so on. So let's see how far we can get with it, and for the time being, and later we will see what we can do with the NumPy package to boost our code. All right, so let's assume we have a Football World Cup sticker album that has a capacity of 600 unique stickers that are consecutively numbered from 1 to 600. So for example, Cristiano Ronaldo has sticker number 140, or Lionel Messi has number 521 or whatever. And our budget allows us to buy 800 stickers. And by buying 800 stickers, we are hoping to complete our album with maximum 200 duplicates. Yeah, that might be a naive start of the game, but for the time being, that's our first approach here. And first of all, we are assigning to the variable album capacity 600. So our album has 600 unique stickers, and we assign purchase to the variable purchase stickers 800. So we are buying 800, and let's see what we get. So before we start creating random numbers and simulating the purchase of our stickers, we have to import the random module. Now we are ready to simulate the random purchase of one sticker, and therefore we are using the method random.randint. So random.randint returns an integer within a given range. So in our case, it should be between 1 and 600, representing 600 unique stickers. And the probability for each number is actually the same. So we have a uniform probability distribution. So let's have a look at Shift Tab. What the help says, so random number integer in range AB, including both endpoints. So 1 to 600, including 1 and 600 should do the job actually. And let's see what we get if we run the cell. Okay, so now we have sticker number 380. So that could be Neymar or Manuel Neuer. And if we repeat this many times, so we are getting different stickers. So 286, let's rerun it again. Sticker number 219. So that's why it's called a random generator. So it randomly generates numbers between, or integers between 1 and 600. So now as we are planning to buy 800 stickers, we have to simulate this process or repeat this process 800 times. And for that task, we will use a for loop. But before we start looping, we are creating an empty list called album, where we are storing all of our stickers or pictures, and we are setting the random seed to 1, 2, 3. So it could be any number. By setting a random seed, and we are creating a so-called pseudo-random numbers, and if you have the same seed as I have, so 1, 2, 3, you are able to fully replicate the numbers I have. So that's quite helpful, actually. So now we can start with our for loop, and we are planning to have 800 iterations, or we are 800 times you want to create one sticker. So we say for e in range purchase stickers, so purchase stickers is 800, and 800 times we are creating a random integer between 1 and 600, so that's our stickers, and we assign it to the variable sticker, and each sticker we then append to our list album. So let's run the cell. Okay, and then we can check what is inside the album. Okay, so we have many stickers here in our album. Yeah, it's a bit not a good overview here, but it's getting an impression that we have stickers inside. But to check how many we have, we are applying the length function. And there it is, so as expected. So we have 800 stickers in our album. Yeah, for now it's a bit a naive approach because we know we cannot have 800 stickers in our album because there's only space for 600. And let's check first how many unique stickers we have in our album. And therefore, we are transforming the list album into a set object and call it unique. So unique does the following: unique removes all duplicates, and that's exactly what we want. And it also sorts here the values as we see. So it starts from 1, 2, 3. So we have sticker 1, 2, 3, 4 until 599 and 600. So and then we can check how many unique stickers we have by again applying the length function. And there it is. So we get 451 unique stickers. So our album is about 75% complete. And we can also make a cross check and get all duplicates. So, and therefore, we are creating a copy of our list album. So we don't want to overwrite album and name it duplicates. And then for each element in unique, or each element in unique, we remove from duplicates. So what should remain in duplicates is actually the duplicates itself. Let's run the cell. Let's check the length. So we would expect if we have 451 unique stickers and we have bought 800 stickers, we would expect to have 349 duplicates. And that's exactly what we have here. So we can also have a look at our duplicates. So which numbers are duplicates? So it's 55, 90. So this list here is not sorted, but yeah, we are not too much interested in duplicates actually. So now we want to focus on our code that it reflects reality better than so far. And I mean, in reality, if we get our sticker, we check if it's in the album, and if it's in the album already, yeah, we are doing nothing. We cannot paste it into the album. And if it's not in the album, we are sticking it into the album, and that's actually what we want to mirror in our code. And therefore, so I've copied here the code from above. We are starting to create an empty list called album. We are setting the random seed 2, 1, 2, 3. So now, then we are starting our for loop. So 800 times we are creating a random number between 1 and 600. That is the sticker. And then we are here introducing a if statement. So we are checking if the sticker we just created is in the album already. We pass, so we are doing nothing. And if it's not in the album, we are appending or sticking it into the album. So let's run the cell and have a look. Okay, so yeah, now we cannot actually see if there are duplicates or not. It shouldn't be, but we can check by applying the length function and check how many unique stickers you have in our album, and it's again 451. So that's not a surprise because our random seed parameter is the same as before. So we end up with 451 unique stickers. And yeah, I mean, it's a bit disappointing. I mean, we are still requiring 149 stickers, and yeah, I assume it's getting a bit more expensive our project than we thought before, actually. All right, so okay, this was one simulation, and maybe we just had bad luck. So maybe if we repeat our process many times, we end up with 500 unique stickers or so on. And yeah, we can check if we manipulate here the seed generator or the seed number to, let's say, 121, then we get a different number of unique stickers, 442, and maybe we change it again to 120. Then we get unique stickers of 453. So there's some variation. So that's because we just randomly generate our numbers, and yeah, there's a statistical variation in our results. But in the end, we want to answer the question, what can we expect on average? And answer this question, we have to simulate this process of buying 800 stickers many time. And so instead of getting only one data point, we get many data points. And the resulting probability distribution of all simulations will give us more information about what we can expect actually. So in the next session, we will create many simulations, but for the time being, we are finished now with this session. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you in the next session.